wire butt welder. You can weld on this machine MS and high carbon wires from 2 to 8 mm dia, copper wires from 2 mm to 5 mm, as well as brass and aluminum. This has to be connected to two lines of three phase, and one earth connection has to be provided through this cable. It has a current variation switch. You can vary the current depending upon the diameter of the wire. Say you want to weld 2 mm plus 2 mm, kindly keep the tap at number 2. Or in case you want to weld 8 mm plus 8 mm, kindly keep the tap at number 6. Here you have a gap adjusting lever, the gap between the two electrodes, which are made from chromium zirconium copper alloy wear resistance. It has got three grooves for different diameter of wires. It has got annealing jaws. It has got spring-loaded foot pedal for opening the gap between the clamping jaws and the welding jaws for inserting the wires like this. Then you can use the pedal so that your jaw gets clamped. Now we'll start actual welding. First, say this is about 5 mm dia wires to be butt welded. For this, we need to adjust the welding current at tap number 4, the pressure at tap number 5. The numbers are mentioned on the brass drum. Now this is 5, you have to coincide with the arrow, so that you get a pressure for welding the 5 mm wires. Similarly, again, this is the gap adjusting lever. You can keep at number 5 for welding 5 mm dia wire, or 8 for welding 8 mm dia wires, or 2 for welding 2 mm dia wires. Now for 5 mm, we'll keep the tap number 5. Clamp the wires to be welded in this way, in the center groove. One this side and one on the left side. Now the wires are clamped. For applying pressure, we need to take this lever back beyond zero point, so that now this job is under pressure. For welding the wire, you can clamp the push the button over here so that welding takes place and the current gets cut off automatically. Now after the weld, you can remove the welded joint, take this lever to the original position, clamp the welded joint in between the annealing jaws so that the welded joint is in center of the annealing jaws. Again, apply a little current for annealing the jaw slowly, slowly, till you get a reddish tinge. See, you get a reddish tinge. It means the weld has been welded properly. You can take out jaw. Do the grinding of the burr all around, and then you can pass through the dies. The diameter wire, say about 6 mm plus 6 mm, again you need to change the current, say from 4 to 5. Change the pressure from 5 to 6. Again, the gap between the two jaws to be set to number 6. Then you can clamp the wires in the bigger groove like this. So that the wires touch midway the lever back beyond zero, so that the wires are under pressure for welding. For welding, to depress this push button, you will observe the welding taking place and current will be cut off automatically. Then you can release the push button, take out the job by depressing the pedal like this. You can take out a job, take this lever back to its own position, clamp the welded joint in midway between the annealing jaws. Depress the same push button 4 or 5 times till you get reddish tinge on the welded joint. You will observe that weld is done properly now. Take out the welded joint, grind the burr all around and pass through dies.